Okay, in this session we're going to do time and work. Okay, what I also want to say at the outset is that this is not a separate topic. It's a creation of the coaching business essentially, but otherwise it is nothing but an application of ratio and rates analysis essentially. Okay, so let's start with a very basic problem, and the kind of language that we would expect in such kind of question scenarios is that, let's say A can do a piece of work in 15 days. Okay, we look at complicated questions later where there is a B involved also, but let's start thinking that A can do a piece of work in 15 days. So A is the name, obviously. This is the number of days, or this is the time involved, and the work is one work, right? Now we might have a problem with just this only. What do we mean by one work? Okay, this work could be anything. This work could be cutting of trees, painting of houses. All of that put together is considered one work. Okay, so my first very basic question would be, if A can do a piece of work in 15 days, how much of the work would he do in 5 days? Okay, that's my question here. Now think about it. The problem is not complicated at all. I know the work gets done in 15 days. That means every day he would be doing some part of the work. Okay, and I'm asking how much of the work is getting done in 5 days. So I know the days are getting 1/3, right? And the relationship between days and work is direct, or time and work we know from our variation discussions is direct. So whatever is happening to the time will happen to the work also. So how much work will get done? 1/3 of the work will get done. Or the longabout way of, I mean, another way of doing this would be that in 15 days all the work is all work gets done. In 1 day, how much of the work will get done? In 1 day, how much? So you will figure that out as 1 by 15 of the work is getting done. So if in 1 day 1 by 15 is getting done, in 5 days how much? 5 times that. So 1 by 15 into 5, right? So where did this 1 by 15 come from? This again came from that the whole thing is getting done in 15 days, right? Or you can start thinking in other directions also. If the whole work is getting done in 15 days, let's say if 2 work had to be done, it would take 30 days, right? We're using basic ratios. Or if we were talking about 7.5 days, I know half the work would be done. So 1 day, how much work is getting done? 1 by 15. So essentially these are the same approaches. It's just that in a lot of books and material, we start with this kind of a fraction and work with that. But otherwise, I hope we see that this is nothing but variation happening as far as one person is concerned. Beyond that, when I bring in another person in the story, it will be nothing but basic additional mathematics getting used. Okay. So let's look at putting two people here. And the story would go like, A can do a piece of work, let's say, in 10 days. And B can do the same work in 12 days. If A and B work together, how long will it take to get the work done? Okay, this is our question statement. A does the work in 10 days, B does the work in 12 days. If they are working together, that means we're creating a third scenario where the work had to be done and A and B were working together. That means their rates were getting added. So how do I do it? So I can call it one work again. The rate for A would be 1 by 10 work per day. 1 by 10 work per day. For B, the rate would be 1 by 12 work per day. I know this would feel uncomfortable because of use of fractions. So later we'll try and think of a method where we can remove the fractions involved. Okay. But this is what is happening, right? Now if A and B are working together, so I mean, and we are thinking of 1 day, A and B working together, how much will they get done? So it will be rate of A plus rate of B in 1 day. So it will be 1 by 10 of W plus 1 by 12 of W. Is that okay? You work this out, you get 60 as a denominator and 11 as a numerator. So in 1 day, or the rate, combined rate of A and B, rate is per day basis, is 11 by 60 of the work. Okay, so now the question was, how long will it take for the work to get done? So I know that time taken for the work, time taken would be total work divided by rate of work. Okay, total work in this case is W and rate of work is 11 by 60 W, right? This WW gets cancelled and I get 60 by 11 as my answer. So if A and B were working together, the work would get done in 60 by 11 days, which would be 5 point something. But overall my answer is okay. Okay, so this is one way of doing it. Stop. Another way of thinking would be, we are using the same concepts here, we are just making lives easy. This is days and we know the work was one work, we were thinking of one work, okay. But let's remove that one work and try and put a number here so that our calculations become easier, and even if the story is complicated, we can use the rate easily instead of using 1 by 10 and 1 by 12, okay. So I know A took 10 days and B took 12 days. A thought jump that I'll make right now is, let's take the LCM of these two, which you saw in the fraction, it was happening in the denominator. Let's take 60 units of work, let's say 60 trees were cut, okay, or 60 houses were painted, yeah, or 60 times up and down somebody drove a vehicle or any such kind of thing, okay. So we are thinking, we are putting up a number, we are just thinking of a situation. Let's say the work is 60 units. So the rate of A now becomes fairly easy to understand. In 10 days, he cut 60 trees. So in one day, how many trees is he cutting? 6 trees, okay. So days, so if you look at it, time into rate, which is work per time, right, will give you work. Time into work per time will give you the work. This is a rate. Any numerator by denominator entity is a rate, and this is the relationship that we are talking about, right? We are given time, we are given work, we are establishing a weight by time relationship. So now B does the same work in 12 days, 60 trees, so per day he would be cutting 5 trees. Yeah, six trees per day and 5 trees per day. Now let's say if they both of them were working together in one day, how many trees would they cut? They would cut 11 trees, right? So the combined rate of A and B is 11 trees per day and 60 trees have to be cut, okay. So how much time will it take? I know 60 trees have to be cut, they are cutting 11 trees in one day. Work should be divided by rate to get the time, right? Work should be divided by rate to get the time. So 60 by 11 would be my answer to get back to my time. Is that okay? Stop. First of all, I mean, an idea that we would want to introduce early, that the so-called topic of pipes and cisterns is the same as time and work, okay? For example, I could say pipe A, I'll just put a P here, pipe A can fill a tank in 10 hours, pipe B can fill the same tank, pipe B can fill the same tank in 12 hours, okay. Hit pause here, think about it, it is the same question. We do not know the tank capacity, let's call it one unit only if you want to, we'll use a standard method. So rate of A per hour, right, or how many units of water are being put per hour would be 1 by 10 units. And for this it would be 1 by 12. I would do the same thing, I would get the total rate as 11 by 60 unit per hour, and I know I have to get one unit. I'll divide the unit by this and I'll get the value, or alternatively I'll take the LCM method only. I know the LCM for 10 and 12 is 60, right? So let's think of the tank as being 60 liters big, it can hold 60 liters. This tank is filling an empty tank in 10 hours. That means how many liters per hour being put? 6 liters per hour is being put. And for tank B, when we do 60 liters, again, how many hours, how many liters per hour? 5 liters per hour. If I put them together, rate of A plus rate of B, it would be how much? It would be 11 liters per hour, right? Think of it as two taps being opened simultaneously. One is giving you 6 liters per hour. The other is giving you 5 liters per hour. So overall per hour you would be getting 11 liters and you have to fill 60 liters. Once again, think about the relationship. 60 liters, 11 liters per hour. Divide the liter by liter per hour and you will get the R value, right? So that would be the same. So the question was the same, just the language was different. And instead of using the fraction, I'm using the LCM and putting up a abstract number there to think of the work. I could have taken any multiple, I could have taken 120 also. Just that when I do that, the visualization becomes slightly easier. And those of you who are scared of fractions, like me, life at least looks easier. Yeah, stop. Okay, thus extending the theory, the story more and more. Let's say in a story, A can do a piece of work in 10 days. B can do the same piece of work in 12 days and C does the same work in 15 days. So we are adding one more person here. My story with either of the methods would not change. I am going for the LCM method first to make it faster. My LCM for 10, 12 and 50 again is 60. So let's say 60 work had to be done, 60 trees had to be cut. So rate for everybody would be 6, 5 and 4. If the question was find the time taken if A, B and C work together, my answer would have been 60 upon 6, 5, 11 and 15, right? So the whole work would have gotten done in 4 days. I could have also asked you that only A and B work together, how long would it take? We've already worked that out. Only A and C, my combined rate would have been 10. Work is getting done is 60. 60 by 10, I would have gotten 6 as the time taken, or 6 days. I could have also figured B and C, my answer would have been 60 by 9 or whatever that value comes out as. Okay, so this is a very basic extension that the story will work for any number of participants. If you were doing it by fractions, this would be 1 by 10 of work, 1 by 12 of work and 1 by 15 of work. Combined rate would have been 1 by 10 plus 1 by 12 plus 1 by 15, right? You can, you know how this works out. LCM in the denominator and all these terms get added in the numerator. Pretty much the same thing. I would prefer the LCM method more often than not because it makes life fairly easy and the calculation becomes straightforward. Yeah, stop.